I want to start to customize the look of this login page right now. I want to change the title. I want to change sort of our mission statement here, and I want to change our logo, the image, the title up here. To access that, we actually have to log in. Admin at admin.com, password. And this stuff is actually in our settings tab down here, so we can go ahead and click that. Okay, and if you look here, we have two different tabs. We have a site tab, which will basically be the defaults that we can set up for the entire app, including the front end. And we also have the admin section here, which is what we want to click to do what we to deal with that login page. So as you can see here, this is the where the admin title would go. This is the sort of mission statement that we have. We can also change the loader, icon image, and the background image, which is that big picture that we had. And that background picture shrinks down to this background. You can see back here behind the name and the avatar, you can see that's the main image that we have. That came with the default Voyager settings that we put in. We can start by changing the title and the name of the project. I've called it the vault, so that's what we're going to name the whole admin panel side. So admin title is the vault, Google Analytics. This is really cool too, because if you have Google Analytics set up, then you can also get the data for those Google Analytics in your admin panel as well, which I think is pretty cool. You would have to sign up for the account and get it up and working first before you can install it, but you know, it's pretty simple to do, and you can check the documentation for that. So, okay, so the description, we're going to say something really simple. So admin panel for the vault. And then we'll add the icon images in a bit and the admin background. Since we're doing all of this as well, I want to change the avatar that we have set here. This is the default one that came, so we're going to change that as well. But let's just see if we got this up and running. So we'll click Save Settings, and then if we log out, you can see that we have the vault here as a new title. This is our mission statement, or our description for the app. And then up here, we've also managed to change the vault and admin. Okay, fantastic. If we head into the text editor, okay, and we open up public, we'll open up storage, app, public. We have this users folder here, and this all three of these folders came with the installation of Voyager, because we installed with dummy data. Okay, and if you open up this user's default, this is the avatar that we have set up. So I want to change this because I want it to be more customized for our needs. So that's one of the images that we're going to change. Now I'm just going to grab a quick image and replace this user's with that image. Okay, so this is the new default image that we're gonna have. The other thing I wanna do is I wanna create another folder in this public folder. And this folder we're gonna call images. And in that folder, I want to open up another one, and we're gonna call it avatar. Okay, and basically, I'm going to copy this image and I'm going to put it in this avatar folder. And I'll explain why in a bit. Okay, so that's good. And the next thing I want to do is in this images folder, I'm going to grab some more pictures to put in. Right in the images folder. So basically, this is going to be our new background image where we have this thing. Okay, so that's the image we're going to have there. And then we're also going to have the vault icon. And that's what we're going to put right down here. Now, in order to get these into our default setup, because basically, if we tried to refresh the database right now, all of these images, this whole folder would just be gone, and so would the image. It would just be replaced by the default Voyager installation. So what we need to do is add to our database seeders So database seeders. The one we need to duplicate now is the settings table seeder. So copy. Paste. Okay, and now this one we can go ahead and rename. And we just need to add custom at the end of this. Okay, so let's make this a bit smaller. And close this one up. Okay, so we need to add the new name here. And if we take a look at this file, you can see this is where it's creating all the settings. So you have the setting site title, the description, logo, and then on the admin side, remember we had two tabs, the site tab and the admin tab. So this one is for the admin side. So what we're going to do is we are going to just go ahead and get rid of all of these and we're going to replace them. Because this is already being seeded anyway. We can now come up here and paste it in, and then I'll show you what the changes are. So all it is we're adding the admin PG image, which is images, which is this BG image here. Okay, we've changed the display name for it. We've added the value. This is the route for it. An image type, order 5. The group that it's in is admin. Then we've added the title, which is the vault. We've given it a value. We've also added the description, admin panel for the vault. These are all things we just did. We're adding the admin icon image. Okay, and that's this image right here. Okay, so that's what's going in that little corner right down here. So before we run that, we need to now work on the app console commands Voyager admin install so that we can set this up in the load default setup that we have for our command. So let's see. First thing we need to do is now bring in the seeder. So copy, paste, and now this one is settings table seeder. So basically the concept of what we want to do is when we run this load this Voyager admin install command, it's going to get rid of all of these three, 1, 2, and 3, and then it's going to reseed it, remigrate it, reseed it, and then add it back. So that's why we are putting the images that we want to maintain in this images folder, because we're not going to touch that. How we're going to do this is, first, when we run this, we want to clear out all of the images that are not in this images folder. Okay, so how we do that is we're going to call the file facade, and we're going to say delete directory, and then the directory we want to delete is in the public path. Okay, and then we're going to be deleting storage users, and that's the one that's right here. So storage users. Let me open up the public folder so that you can see it a bit clearer. From this folder, we're going to delete the users folder. Oh, we also need to import this. Import class. And it is the facade. So now we're going to create a variable. And in this variable, we're just going to say copy success equals file copy directory public path. And now what we need to do is copy the storage images avatar folder and the public path storage users. Now, if you decide to just not install the defaults like we did, the dummy data for Voyager, then you can customize this however you want to customize it. But basically, you just want to make sure that all of the images that you have are deleted and then just sort of re-uploaded in the correct folders that they need to be in. Now we can call if copy success this info images successfully copied to storage folder. Now, this file delete directory and then copying it over, we just want to make sure that we maintain the default images. So the front image, the icon image, the background image, that stuff, as well as our default avatar, our custom default avatar, are stored in the storage images folder. And this way, when we do reinstall it, this default will just... it'll stay. We're not deleting it or anything, but it'll be copied over to this users folder when we're getting ready to run this command. Let's say we get ready to put it on a server and we need to run that command. Those images will already be in there. What I would probably do in this situation is, instead of putting it in our app, if I was putting it on a server, I would have some sort of server based like S3, or I tend to use DigitalOcean, and I keep some spaces in there in order to hold all of my images, and then just link those images to whatever we're doing here. This is just to set you up on your server once you get up and running, or even to allow you to customize things the way you want while in development, so that you don't have to keep fixing over and over again the same thing. Like, let's say you just want to change the title, and then you end up, for whatever reason in your development, needing to reseed and end up losing that information. So this is just to keep us kind of consistent and help to speed up development when you're working on something like this. Everything that you've changed, you can bring it to your server. And then once you have it up online, then you can just change everything else right within the app. Anything like the image, if you want to change this, you can change that within the app. This is in the event that anything happens to your database, you can at least have that backup information within the app itself to run when you need it to run. So it's just, it really is just sort of to kind of cover your bases. And with that being said, let's come back here. So great, let's go ahead and now run this command. So it's php artisan Voyager admin install. We'll go ahead and run that. This will delete all current data. Yes. Okay, it's really not going to change much for us now, because we don't have any user profile images, and we don't have any yet from the Jetstream package in our images, in our storage folder yet. So it's not going to change anything just yet, but it will down the road, and I'll show you that when we get to it. And now it's finished running. And if we go up to where it started, it says images successfully copied to storage folder, and now we should be good to go. Okay, so let's now go ahead and refresh our page. Okay, and as you can see, even refreshing our page, we have our new title up there. We have our new title here. We also have our description, our icon, and we also have our image. So now we fully customized it how we wanted to. And you can also change the sizing on it. You can do whatever you want. You can set this up however you want. But I would take a look at the Voyager documentation, and I would also take a look at the settings cedar that we have to see if there's anything else that you might want to add to it. Okay, but I think we pretty much covered the essentials of what it was we wanted to change. Fantastic. I'm going to leave it there, and in the next episode, we are going to be looking at the user avatars and setting that up. I'll make sure to push all this code up to GitHub. I'll leave a link for it down in the description so you guys can go and check out the code. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.